Hello, welcome back to the OBIS data formatting series. We have already created the core event table, and now we will be formatting the occurrence extension table. Let's start by identifying all fields related to occurrences. So of course we'll need the eventID, parent eventID, the species occurrences, the percent cover. So we will copy these, create a new sheet, which we will call occurrence, and paste the values. Now we have to add required columns for the occurrence table. So that is occurrence ID, basis of record, and occurrence status. So let's fill in occurrence status first. All records have a percent cover greater than zero, so we know they will all have the present status. For basis of record, we know that no specimen was collected, they were only observed, so we will write human observation. Now we must create unique occurrence IDs. And before that, let's delete the rows that don't have any occurrence record. Currently, there are no specific guidelines on how to construct an occurrence ID, so we can build it from the event ID by adding numbers to the end of the event ID. So to do this, we'll create one extra column to ensure we have a list of numbers to concatenate. We will not be publishing this column with the rest of our data, so we can just call it ID. For this column, we will simply do 1 through the number of records. If you have existing identifiers for each occurrence, you can also use this in place of creating your own identifier. So then for occurrence ID, we will concatenate the event ID, add another underscore, and then concatenate it with our individual ID. Apply this formula to each record, and now we have a unique identifier for each of our occurrences. Because it's a formula, we want to copy and then paste values in place, so these will not change. So next we must map our terms to Darwin Core. So species will become scientific name. Now we'll need another column, which will be scientific name ID. You can obtain scientific name identifiers from the World Register of Marine Species, or WORMS. Please see the WORMS tutorial video for help obtaining these identifiers and putting them back in your data. So let's make some notes in the documentation tab to capture all of these changes. First, we change species to scientific name. For occurrence ID, we created a new column called ID, and then concatenated the new column with our event ID. For basis of record and occurrence status, it was inferred from the data. Both of them were inferred from data. And that's it for our occurrence table. Your data might have more columns to fill in, so please see the OBIS Manual Term Checklist for help in identifying potential Darwin Core terms to include. Next, we will format the extended measurement or fact extension table.